Hello everyone and welcome to my channel Engineering Mind Center. Now in the last two lectures we were discussing about codes. Now this is the part 3 of that lecture, that is introduction to codes part 3. Now in this part we are going to study another type of codes which are non-weighted codes, which come under the category of non-weighted codes, and they are known as gray codes. Now in this lecture we will understand what is a gray code and what are its applications. So first point, which I had stated earlier, that gray code is a non-weighted code. Now what is the meaning of non-weighted code? Suppose thing, if I have a gray code, let's say 0011. Let us assume that this is a gray code which I am having, then every bit in this number will not have any positional weight. No positional weight will be associated. No positional weight will be associated. Whereas if this number was a binary code, let us assume if this number was a binary code, then you know a positional weight is assigned to each bit position. This is 2 raised to 0 position, this is 2 raised to 1, this is 2 raised to 2, and this is 2 raised to 3 position. But this thing is absent in your gray code. That's the reason it is known as non-weighted code. So no positional weight will be associated when a number is encoded in gray code format. So this is the first and most important property, that gray codes fall under the category of non-weighted codes. So from this property only we can derive another property. When I say that this code is a non-weighted code, by that I mean that no positional weight is associated with individual bit positions. So from that only one comes to know that it is not an arithmetic code. So these were few properties of the gray code. Now we will move on to study how a gray code practically looks like. Now how to write this gray code, or how will you find the gray code of the equivalent decimal number or binary bit pattern? So this is the table in front of you. Here I have written gray code equivalents, decimal equivalents, corresponding binary equivalents, and its corresponding gray code equivalent for decimal numbers starting from 0 to decimal number 59, and written the corresponding gray codes. Now how will you get the gray codes, that is the next thing, or how will you compute gray codes, that we will discuss later. But why I have drawn this side by side is to make you understand some of the important properties of the gray code. Now understand that gray code is also known as a unit distance code. Now why it is known as a unit distance code? The reason for that is pretty much simple, because see, if you see the gray code equivalent of decimal number 0 and gray code equivalent of decimal number 1, you can see that, observe that only one bit is changing from here. So whenever we compute the gray code from one number to another, the difference between the two successive gray codes or any gray code will have only one digit which is different. Now observe here, gray code equivalent for 2 and gray code equivalent for 3. So here we have gray code equivalent for 2 is 0011 and gray code equivalent for 3 is 0010. So observe here that only one bit is changing, this one. So when I incremented and I wanted to compute gray code for 3, then only one bit is changing. So what was gray code equivalent of 2, that was 0011. Now when I want to compute gray code equivalent of 3, only one bit is changing, this bit. This last bit has changed from 1 to 0. So that's the reason it is known as a unit distance code, because only one bit is changing. One bit change only. Between two gray codes, only one bit changes. So that is an advantage. That is an advantage when it comes to transmission errors. So when we transmit gray codes, we know that only one bit changes between the two successive decimal equivalents or in the particular coding. Same is the case with 8 and 9 also. Only you can observe that only you can see any number of patterns over here in gray code. Only one bit is different from the previous one. So one bit change only is there. So that is an important property, and it is, that's the reason it is known as unit distance code. Only one bit changes. So to be more precise, we can define as only one bit changes in gray code. Only one bit changes in gray code when the decimal number is incremented by 1. So this is known as unit distance code. So gray code is a non-weighted code. Second property is a unit distance code. And the third property which we are going to study of gray code is the reflective property of the gray code. Now what do you mean by reflective property of a gray code? Now let us understand what do you mean by reflective property of gray code. Property of gray code. Now observe. Now as I told you earlier, in gray code only one bit changes from the previous digit, if decimal so. Only one bit change is there from the successive equivalents. So observe here that when I talk of reflective property, now observe the two LSBs of the gray code over here from 0 to 7. Observe the two LSBs which I have underlined over here to explain the reflective property. And similarly from 8 to 9, observe these two LSBs. Observe these two LSBs. So let us first see this table from 0 to 7 and understand what are these LSBs doing here. So these last two LSBs I have underlined. So we are going to observe from 0 to number 7. Okay. So I have underlined last two LSBs from 0 to 7. Now if I draw a line from between 0 to 3. 0 to 3. So and I have underlined these LSBs. Now what is reflective property? So observe this. This is 10, last two LSBs only observed. Decimal equivalent gray code for 4 is 10, last two bits of it 11, 01, 00. And observe that the decimal the gray code equivalent for decimal numbers 4 to 7 last two LSBs are mirror images. So if you observe from 4 to 7 decimal equivalent, this portion only, that is 10110100, the same thing is reflected over here. Are they simply mirror images? That is, last two LSBs are simply mirror images. So from this pattern, if you observe, these last two bits for decimal equivalents 4 to 7 of the gray code are same for the last, are the same LSBs, but they are reflected upwards. So here 10 was there, so here also 10 is
understood
there. So that's the reason it is called as reflective code, because the last two LSBs are mirror images of each other. That is, the last two LSBs for the gray code equivalent for 4 to 7 are the mirror images of the last two LSBs of 0 to 3 decimal equivalents. So this was one important thing of the reflective property, is that the last two LSBs, I'm writing, the last two LSBs for decimal four to seven are mirror images. For last two LSBs for decimal number 0 to 3. So this is known as reflective property, because the last two bits patterns are mirror images. Now another important point concerning the reflective property also. Now we observed last two LSBs for decimal numbers 0 to 7. Now we will observe last three LSBs and check whether the last three LSBs from 0 to 15 exhibit the reflective property or not. So for that we will take into account the last three LSBs. Now I have underlined last three LSB bits starting from 0 to 15 decimal equivalent. And I am underlining only the gray code part of it. I am ignoring the binary code for now. I am only discussing the properties of gray code. So binary code I have written only for reference. So now we are going to observe last three LSB bits and check its reflective property. So I have underlined last three LSB bits of the following code over here, starting from 0 to 15. Now let us study this. Now for studying this, observe this table separately and this table separately. So this one and second table individually you assess, and now you forget this line between 0 to 3 and 3 to 4, this line you forget, and observe, analyze this table completely. And we have to observe last three LSB bits and check its reflective property. Now observe that this is the equivalent gray code for decimal digits 0 to 7, and this is the equivalent gray code for decimal digits starting from 8 to 15. Now observe last three LSBs. Now you can observe from this table only we'll start first. Decimal equivalent of 8, by gray code equivalent of 8 is 1100. Now we are interested only in last three LSBs. So 1100, 101, 111, 110, 010, 011, 001 and 000. Now observe that. So this last three LSBs I have read for 8 to 15. Now let us compare with the last three LSBs of this one. So what are the last three LSBs for decimal equivalent 0 to 7, gray code equivalent of decimal number 0 to 7? That is, see here, 000, 001, 011, 010, 110, 111, last three LSBs, 101 and 100. Now, when I read these two, you can clearly observe that from the gray code equivalence for decimal digits 8 to 7, last 3 LSBs are nothing but are reflected back over here. See, here there was 10 over there. So, observe, here there was 100. So, here there is also 100. Here there was 101. So, here is also 101. So entire bit pattern is reflected back. So the thing which we reflective property which we observed for 2 LSBs is valid for 3 LSBs as well. So for that the statement will be related to reflective property. The last 3 LSBs a decimal numbers 8 to 15 are mirror images for gray code equivalent of decimal number from 0 to 7. So this is nothing but the reflective property of gray code. So gray code is a non-weighted code, it is a non-arithmetic code, and it exhibits the following reflective property, and which I have discussed in greater detail over here. So now the last and most important property is the cyclic property of the gray code. What is the meaning of cyclic property? Gray code is also known as cyclic code. Now observe the table to the left over here. We have decimal number 0, its corresponding binary code and its corresponding gray code. So what is this gray code equivalent for decimal 0? That is 4 times 0. And observe here, in the second column, in the second table, last row, which was the decimal for the decimal equivalent 15, the corresponding gray code is 1000. Now observe this one. When I write gray code for 0, which is 0000, and when I write gray code for 15, you can observe that despite being this being the first entry and this being the last entry of the code, you can observe only one bit change over here. So only MSB changes from 0 to 1. So only one bit change is there here also. So we say that the code is cyclic. So if we take any of these numbers, whether it is the last one or the first one, only one bit change will be present. That's the reason it is known as a cyclic code. And it has, because of this property, it is used in wide variety of applications. So there are wide variety of applications for this gray code, but we are going to just list them. Detail, if you want to study, you can study. There are various resources available on internet for this. But the most important thing which we should know that the gray code obeys cyclic property, reflective property, and it is a non-weighted code. Now after studying all the properties of gray code, now we will move on to study how to convert given binary equivalent or binary code to gray code, or how to find gray code equivalent of a binary number. So now we will understand how to compute gray code equivalent from compute gray code from its equivalent binary code. Now how will you compute gray code from binary, that I am going to teach over here. But before that, we need to learn something known as, which is known as modulo 2 addition. So what is this modulo 2 addition? I have written the rules over here. And this plus in circle within a circle is the symbol for modulo 2 addition. Whenever see a plus sign inside a circle, then you should know that it follows the rules of modulo 2 addition of Boolean algebra or binary arithmetic. This modulo 2 addition is simple. We will learn this in greater detail in future lecture lessons of our course. But for time being, you will only remember these four rules and its significance with respect to computation of gray code. So these are the rules. Now 0 modulo 2 addition 0 is 0. 0 modulo 2 addition 1 is 1. And 1 modulo 2 addition 0 is 1. And 1 modulo 2 addition 1 is 0. So simply remember that is this is something some different type of addition wherein these are the rules to be followed. Now we move on to gray code conversion. Now this is a binary code or binary number which we are having. We want to convert it into its equivalent gray code equivalent. So for that we will write this number again, which is in binary. So this is 1011. Now look closely over here. This one is the MSB, and we want to convert this entire number to gray code. So for that, what we will do, we will start conversion process. So when we are converting from binary to gray, MSB for binary and MSB for gray code is the same. So same thing I will copy it down over here. Then again, I will put a modulo 2 sign over here. Now what I am supposed to do? So the next bit to the MSB and the MSB bit, I am supposed to modulo 2 add. So this one XOR with 0, we will study XORing later. But for time being, remember this is modulo 2 addition. So 1 modulo 2 addition 0, answer will be 1. So that is in accordance with this modulo 2 addition rules. Now the next bit we want to find, so we'll put a modulo 2 addition sign. Then what we will do, this on top of it 1 is there, and this 0 we have to modulo 2 add. So 0 modulo 2 addition 1, so 0 modulo 2 addition 1 is nothing but 1. Then we will put another modulo 2 addition sign below the next bit. Then how this one and this one we will modulo 2 add. So the previous bit and we will modulo 2 add with the next bit. So 1 modulo 2 addition 1 is nothing but 0. So this is the equivalent gray code for this binary number. So it is pretty much simpler. So if you want to understand it in this manner, it will be much more simpler. Now let's say we will label the numbers. This was the binary number given to us, right? 1011. This was the binary number, and this was the gray code equivalent we computed. So see, now let us label the digits. This is nothing but B3, B2, B1, B0. And as this number is in, we have converted into gray. Now we have, this is G3, G2, G1, and G0. Now in order to remember this conversion process, now we know that G3 is the MSB bit of the gray code. So G3 MSB is equal to B3 MSB, because we copied down the same thing while conversion. So this is the conversion process only in terms of equation I am writing now. When we want to obtain the second bit of gray code, that is G2, we will obtain by modulo 2 addition of the third bit of binary number, modulo 2 addition B2. So when you want to obtain the first bit of gray code, similarly it will be B2 modulo 2 B1. Similarly, when you want to compute 0th bit of this gray code, it will be nothing but B1 XOR B0. So this binary to gray code conversion procedure which we did here earlier, I have written in the form of equation, so it would be easier for you to remember and compute equivalent gray code when equivalent binary is given. So So this for these things in the box, if you remember, you can easily remember this procedure and compute any gray code equivalent of given binary number. Now we will study its reverse case. Suppose thing, if we are given a gray code and we want to find its equivalent binary code or binary number. So how will you do that? First write the given gray code, that is 1110 in this case. Then copy down the MSB as it is. Put a modulo 2 addition sign to the next bit. Now remember that we have copied down the MSB as it is for binary conversion. Now what we have to do, we have to this MSB we have copied down as it is in the binary number form. So this one we have to modulo 2 add with the next digit of the Greek code. So the I have shown an arrow, 1 modulo 2 addition 1. So answer will be 0. Then again in next step we will take this answer and modulo 2 add with the next bit in the gray code. That is 0 modulo 2 addition 1, answer will be 1 as per the rules of modulo 2 addition. 1 modulo 2 addition 0, answer will be 1. So when we do all these steps, the final answer which we get is an equivalent binary code for the given gray code. Now see, this is 1110, this is a gray code and its equivalent binary is 1011. We computed this. Now how will you write the same thing in terms of equations so that it would be easier for you to remember this convergence? So MSB we copied down as it is. So the MSB bit of the equivalent binary bit will be same as the, so this is B3, B2, B1, B0. Okay. This is G3, G1. G2, G0. Now remember, the MSB bit for this equivalent, actually I have written reverse, so this should be exactly. This was your gray code, na? In this example, G3, G2, G1, G0, and this will be B3, B2, B1, B0. So now we will write in terms of equations. Now both the MSBs we copied down as it is as per our procedure for convergence. So B3 is equal to G3. Now what will be the next step? You when we want to find second equivalent binary bit, we will add B2 modulo 2 addition G1. Same thing we did here. See, this is our B2 modulo 2 addition G1 equivalent gray code bit. So B2 modulo 2 addition G1. Sorry, it is not G1, it is G2. So this is 1, which is the equivalent binary representation. So this is B3 and this is G2. So this is B3 and B3 modulo 2 addition G2 to obtain the second bit. Okay. Then we want to obtain first binary bit, binary bit at position number 1. So this bit we want to compute. So for that what we will do? B2 modulo 2 addition G1. The same thing which we did over here. And the last bit, that is B0th bit at the 0th position is nothing but B1 modulo 2 addition G0. So this procedure which I had explained you earlier, the same thing I have written only in the form of equations so that it would be easier for you to remember this convergence. So in university exams or any competitive exams, many a times there are questions for binary to gray code conversion, and reverse case is also asked sometimes, that is gray code to binary, binary to gray and gray to binary. So this was how will you convert when you have a given code to another code. Now let us move on to study applications of gray code. Now the first application. So gray codes are useful for transmission of digital signals because they have less chances of error. So when we transmit a gray code, there are very few chances of getting an error while transmission or wrong bit pattern or interpretation and or transmission of this thing cut let us study applications of gray code. Now the first application of gray code is in transmission of digital signal. So whenever in a digital system or any system in particular we want transmissions or the transmitted data to be transmitted in an error free fashion when it flows to the channel. So when we transmit digital data, in form of gray code, it is transmitted in a error free fashion because of the use of gray code, occurrence of errors in the code will be less because only one bit changes from the equivalent from the previous one. That's why this occurrence of errors will be less, and that's why it is used in transmission of digital signals. That is, gray code is used in transmission of digital signal. Now then the second application is while labeling K-map. Now what is this K-map? We will understand in greater detail in the next few lectures of our course, but for time being remember that this K-map simplification is used for minimizing your digital system equation. And this gray codes are used for labeling this K-map, and because of which it is easier to minimize the system equation so that the complexity of system reduces. Now this K-map part we will discuss in greater detail throughout our course, then only you will understand what was the utility of gray code here. So for time being just list it down over there that it is used while labeling K-map, which is used for minimizing your digital system equation or Boolean equation. Now the third important application, it is used in angular measurement. Angular measurement devices. Now what is the meaning of this? Gray codes are used in various angular measurement devices. So when we are encoding a particular bit pattern, let's say for example, I have a gray code that is 000 and I have encoded it to certain angles, let's say. So when I write 000, I am assuming that this is something 90 degrees. For example, this is not hard and fast, different encoders use different type of coding. So when I have gray code pattern, this is the equivalent angular measurement. And this encoding table I have designed in my encoded in my digital system, that whenever the gray code of 000 is received, then you understand that angle of 90 degrees being read. So that's the reason it is used in angular measurement devices, and it is error free because only one bit changes, and that's the reason gray code is used in angular measurement devices. And why binary code is not used in this case? Supposing if I have binary code, let's say 1111 0, and then I can assign any angle, or the designer can assign any angle to angular measurement device in this case. But straight binary code is not used because observe here any number of bits can change at a given point of time. So it can happen that the angle can be misread by the device. So in order to avoid this error, what we do is angular measurement devices use gray code only to read the corresponding angular measurements. So gray code is widely used in angular measurement devices. And fourth, genetic codes. Now, what is this genetic code? Genetic codes, this basically is an application from your medical field where scientists or virologists study different type of genetic codes and defects. These codes are generally incremental in nature. And one knows that gray code is also incremental in nature and only one bit is changed from the previous one. So if this is the gray code and this is the gray code obtained in the previous step, then in the next for the next digit the gray code will be 0011. So only one bit change is there, so we can understand gray code is also incremental in nature and genetic codes are also incremental in nature. So we use gray, so medical professionals, when they study these genetic codes, they make use of gray codes because it matches the property of the biological genetic codes they are studying. That is, both of these codes are incremental in nature. And the last application, which is related to your microprocessors or memory addressing. So your microprocessors or computers, I'll write it over here. Microprocessors use gray code for addressing purposes. So microprocessors use gray codes for memory location addressing purposes. And why gray codes are used? So when we use gray codes for microprocessor or memory location addressing, we need only a fewer number of address lines to be activated. So this results in low power consumption. So what are these address lines and all? With respect to microprocessor, you will study in 5th semester in microprocessors and application. So for time being, remember that they are used for addressing purposes in your microprocessors because only a few number of address lines needs to be activated. That's the reason and it in turn results in low power consumption. That's the reason we use gray codes while addressing in microprocessors or microcontrollers. So that's all for the day. If you like this video, please do like, share and subscribe my channel. And please don't forget to hit the bell icon to get notification of all my latest uploads. Thank you.